Attention. Pump failure imminent. All personnel, abandon ship.
Yeah.
Launch in 3, 2, 1.
Okay, so we're on fire. Good start to anything. Let's go ahead and extinguish, get rid of this thing so we can start the wonderful series that is Subnautica. Hello everyone and welcome back. We are, well, as crash landed as ever. Let's see.
Greetings, survivor. Great job not dying. To assist you in further survival in emergency situations, you have been issued this personal data assistant. The interface visible now will organize your inventory, display currently available construction blueprints, and holds other valuable information. Please take a moment to familiarize yourself with it.
Okay. Well, cool. Looks like they have a little bit more instruction going on. But I want to first off just put the extinguisher away. We got some flares, nutrient block, water. Things to hold us over here in damaged life pod systems.
Life pod hull secure. Communication.
Oh, that's good.
Offline.
Okay. And we're gonna repair that. Our chair. No point in repairing that. Some sort of. I think this is where the actual fire extinguisher was. Anyways, let's head up. All right, we are, you know, lady, I'm trying to commentate here.
0 human life signs detected in 100 meter range.
I forgot how beautiful this game was. It's been that long. I mean, we haven't played since before the exosuit came out. So there's a whole lot of stuff for me to go over and discuss as we work through Subnautica.
Oxygen, nitrogen, atmosphere.
Just head down and just go straight into the water and start working on progress here. Ooh. The sounds feel like they're heavier. Everything feels a little bit more polished than before, which is good. Gonna need that. Hello, peepers. Come here. I need you for potential food.
New creature discovered.
All right, we got a peeper. There we go. Hey, 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 don't get excited. Calm down. I know, I'm back in the game. Relax.
Oxygen.
Gonna need the, oh, gonna need some mushrooms as well. This will help us
oxygen
work. All right, there's the pod. So I hope a lot of the kind of little stuttery issues
programmed to construct tools and render organic substance.
All right, you too.
Copper is an essential component of all powered
equipment. Whoa, stalker.
Survival.
Get out of here.
Increased by 11%.
Why is the stalker doing so far away from the reef?
Discovered. Attention, detecting increased local radiation levels. Trend is consistent with ongoing degradation.
All right, let's cook some
food. Aurora's dark matter drive core due to damage sustained during collision. Continuing to monitor.
Okay,
the fabricator,
so we got that.
Small organisms.
Whoa.
While disposing of the skeletal structure,
body, all these additional
and
items.
Organs, thus rendering them safe for human consumption.
It feels like we kind of know what we're doing already, and every time they give us hints and tips, it's just like, yeah, but I've done this once or twice, so relax a little bit. It's a little smoky in here. You can see all the smoke rising up. Kinda. Do we have the top just open? Are we venting this? Are we going to die? No? Okay. Just making sure. Let's go ahead and eat that. That'll tide us over for a little while. and I need to gather up some metal, some quartz, and basically start constructing some basic gear for us here. Whoa. Oh, yeah, that's the vent. Forgot about that thing. Yeah, everything just sounds a little bit more basic. Lead. Don't give me lead this early. It's not something I want. Salt, though. We'll just hold on to a couple pieces of that. Not super relevant this early. Yeah, I'm still getting FPS drops here. It's something I'm going to look into. In fact, if you guys know anything to kind of fix the stuttering that I get in Subnautica, it's really the only game that does it. Do let me know. And if you have any sources to assist with that as well, feel free to leave a link in the comments just so I can see it and hopefully move on as I get chased by a stalker. Here we go. I always thought it had to do with the terrain generation and how it loads and unloads. It might not be doing it in a smooth, efficient manner. But now I'm just starting to think that it's something else. Could be like a corrupt file. I am on the development branch of the game. A little different than normal. Let's cook a Gary fish real quick. And munch that down. Alright, so we have some acidic mushrooms, we have some lead, some salt, and metal. Let's get the metal melted down into titanium. And we'll worry about getting some of our gear. So we need an oxygen tank, of course. That will prolong our underwater breathing capacity. Personal equipment. And what's this? Floating air pump? Floating device that pumps air into pipes. Acts as a starting point for a pipe chain. That's new. Pump air to faraway places. It feels like the pipes might have gotten reworked there, and that might be useful for going down into the ravines and things. We need a piece of glass. There we go. Oh, come on. I'm barely clicking off of it. Okay, so we have our tank. Which is good. I think that automatically equips. We need some fins, and we don't really need another fire extinguisher. We have one. Can I make a battery yet? I can. So I'll go ahead and make a scanner in case we come across any recipe fragments here in the beginning.
Can be used to synthesize blueprints from salvaged technology and to record alien biological.
Yeah, she'll tell you what that means. It's just recording and telling us how things work, and also how you do some research here early on. We need a whole bunch of quartz, probably. Probably also need some more acidic mushrooms. I did equip the O2 tank, right? Yep. It did that automatically. Good old event doing wonderful things. Now, you know, it's up to us if we really want to just scan everything or not. It's kind of a little bit of a RP aspect, you know, alien life forms here. The fish are much harder to do because they are moving.
Creature discovered.
Something to consider. We got a bladder fish, which is good.
May have unexpected characteristics and applications. Utilizing alien resources is a proven survival strategy. Goo.
Oh, they had an animation to the outside ladder. That's pretty cool. And we are venting out the inside. Don't know where the smoke's still coming from, but maybe once we get this repaired, it's probably a combination of this panel and our battery cells leaking lithium into our lungs. I'm sure it's fine. Not worried. Get some filtered water there. And we'll cure food on this one. Just so it stays a bit longer with us. I don't know how much longer it can stay. Let's see. We need some rubber. Creepvine seed cluster. It's dark. Back up. Hold on. Let's see, tools, flashlight, battery, glass, got it. So, glass, and we need a battery, which is copper ore. Great. Enter the darkness.
Of the Aurora's drive core may cause a quantum detonation. calculating risk assessment. Death by malnourishment, 7%. By physical injury, 11%.
Okay, that's
by
not bad.
To radioactive crash site materials.
90%. I can scan myself?
If the drive core is breached, probability of death
I have foreign bacteria.
65%. Performing self-scan. Vital signs normal.
Wow.
Detecting trace amounts of foreign bacteria. Continuing to monitor.
Well, good for you. We need a name for our computer as well. If you guys want to name her, she will be keeping us company here during the series.
30 seconds.
30 seconds until death. Except for there is air leaking out of something over here. That's not showing up on my screen. Maybe it's just buried. No, no. Okay, so I need to find some deposits. A little hard to do at night, since you can't quite see as well. Wow, so many fish swimming around. It feels like it's a lot more populated than the last time I played. Here, little outcrops. We may have to go into the more reed area for that. Let's scan some more things. Can't scan those. I can scan the writhing weed. Okay.
Oxygen.
Oh, we're gonna die. So, okay. So, the actual rocks that we can break are probably a little bit deeper than we were, and generally more close to the vines. But also hostiles over here as well. So we'll stay on the surface. The Aurora is quite the beautiful ship if it wasn't on fire and wouldn't look like a moon was about to collide into its engine bay. Okay, a little bit of lag. We're fine though. We'll just move on and hope for the best. Not as dark as it used to be, which is good. Oh, wow. Oh, what is that? What are you? Get off! Get off! What was that thing? It stuck to my arm! Okay. Ow. That hurt and was not nice at all. Bladder fish. Now, hopefully we have enough to make some fins because slowing, you know, having such a slow swim speed is not ideal for survival. Oh, good. We do have one med kit to use and I'll go ahead and use it. Eat that. And I need to make, come on. Tools, a battery, which we went down there for the wrong thing. That's great. That's perfect. Exactly what I wanted. Let's just make some silicone rubber. Equipment. We need two, don't we? Yeah. But we can make a survival knife at least, because we're gonna need that.
Weapons were removed from standard survival blueprints following the massacre on Abraxas Prime.
Wow.
An essential survival tool for 2.5 million years. The knife remains the only exception. Sorry about that.
Why would they remove weapons? Like, what happened at the other place? Did we destroy the local population? Did we wipe out a species? Obviously something is up with that. Alright, so I need to gather two more of these seed pods here. Back up, back up. Get out of here. Get out of here. It's like a dog. Please leave. He's not leaving. Quartz. Quartz is always nice. Stop chasing me and eat the thing. quartz. Still nice. We don't need any more mushrooms. Stop!
Oxygen.
What are you chasing me for? I didn't do anything. Are you my pet now? Should I scan you? I'll go ahead and scan him. Let's add him to our system. Good old stalker guy. It's like catching Pokemon at this point. Pokedex complete. Perfect. Oh, some rock outcrop. Great. Maybe we can get some copper. Nope, titanium. Great. It seems like I can never get exactly what I need.
Warning.
Okay, got it.
Level radiation readings exhibit characteristics consistent with total degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core.
It's fine. Don't worry about it.
Will occur with a probability of 85.5.
That's fine. That's fine.
Advise observing of 1 kilometer.
You guys jump out of the water now? That's adorable. Good old peepers. Inventory secure. We are safe and sound. Fabricator. We are going to make some rubber. These will be for our fence and starting equipment. A battery for our flashlight for when it becomes nighttime. An air bladder. That just gets us to the surface quicker. I'm not too worried about that. So, flashlight, check. Did I get rid of one of the rubber? Did I burn a rubber to make a flashlight? No. I don't think I did. Didn't I already make one of these? I swear. Am I going crazy? I'm going crazy. Okay. Well, that's fine. We got a flashlight at least. Back into the depth we go. So Subnautica is definitely one of the examples of how to properly support and develop a survival game. You know, it has a unique setting, one of course being in water, very different than normal. I think they also solve a lot of the problem with the hunger and water system that everyone kind of finds a little annoying. Go away, I'm not a fish. Die, get out of here. Ugh. What a jerk. Stab him a couple times and leaves me alone. Oh, air. Okay, well, we got one of those. The name of the game is staying low so you can stay down here for longer and get materials for longer as well. About saving time in terms of going up and down. Okay, so we get the extra seed. This will get us our second silicone, and now we'll have fins, which will drastically increase our glide kind of swim speed here. And then we need to worry about possibly working on our first mechanical swim device, being the sea glide. I don't know if they changed how to get those, but it is a concern of mine because I've been out of the loop for so long. Because really, I wanted to try and maintain some, I guess, naive thoughts about the game. And I didn't want to spoil it for myself. And I've heard they've added quite a lot of story elements to it. So I think now is a decent time to kind of hop back in. Okay, let's get some water real quick. Just drink that right away. And then some rubber. We'll have to start growing these things as well. And then some fins. Perfect. Alright, lady gonna tell us what the fins do? Okay, you guys need to work on your jump animation. This is basically making Bethesda look amazing. Okay, we got titanium, we got plenty of that, we got some copper, we got some quartz. We're a little bit quicker now.
Emergency.
We might need a vehicle bay or something. Where's the Sea Glide? Is it in here?
The central dark matter reactor will reach a supercritical state.
No, deployables.
10,
grav sphere.
9,
wait.
8,
is
7,
this blowing up right now?
6, 5,
like right 4, right now?
3, 2.
Whoa, it still looks awesome. So obviously, this means the front of the ship housed the power core. Let's get inside before radiation maybe hurts us. Oh, our flashlight. Ah! Boop, boop. Okay. Let's go ahead and do a self-scan after that. Come on, complete. I'm infected? Infected by what? Not gonna tell me, lady in the sky? Okay, that's fine. We're infected and alone. And we're getting a beeping message. Is it from this? Maybe it was saying it was ready, but maybe this... No, we can't use it, so looks like it doesn't cure our infection. By any means. I'll down this titanium. Go into the blueprints here, and as a final bit, the sea moth, ingredients unknown, a base attached air pump. Pumps air into pipes, acts as a starting point for a pipe chain. So you can pipe away from that. Hatching enzymes, mysterious enzymes. I have no clue what that is. The grav sphere, don't know what that is either, really. I'm not seeing Mr. Seaglide. It might be a researchable kind of thing, and I forgot. Okay, well, we're gonna have to figure this out as we go, it seems like. So, here we are, again, at the start of Subnautica. I hope you guys enjoy the series and how things are going. If you have any tips and tricks on solving a little bit of the lag problems between, I think it's the terrain generation, I'm most likely wrong. The community most likely already knows that. I'm going to search for some things as well and see if I can't correct that just for recording's sake. Hit that like button if you want to see more Subnautica. Check out my other videos. I do a whole bunch of creative stuff here on the channel. And I'll see you guys later where we will swim around in the ocean. Like a fish.